I'm Carole Cusack. I'm Professor of Religious Studies at the University of Sydney. It's the most amazing opportunity for me to be here at the Centre for the Study of World Religions at Harvard Divinity School working on this project. This really important academic piece of work on George Ivanovich Gurdjieff, who's really understudied in both the fields of esotericism and new religious movements. And the work that's happening here this semester is going to really go some distance in rectifying that neglect. I think the best place to start always is Meetings with Remarkable Men, the book that's called the second series. Gurdjieff's three big books are usually referred to collectively as All and Everything. Beelzebub's Tales is a very difficult read and it's also extremely long, whereas Meetings with Remarkable Men is a relatively short book and it's a sequence of chapters about remarkable people. Men, I might say, though there is one woman featured in the book that Gurdjieff allegedly met over the years when he was accumulating spiritual wisdom. It's better to realise that it's not a straightforward autobiography. It's more like a literary representation of a spiritual journey. But it's very easy to read and interesting and diverting. If that takes root and you decide you want to read more, the book that most people would recommend, and I agree, is to move to Uspensky as an author. And his In Search of the Miraculous is the most systematic and the most organized kind of written version of the Gurdjieff teachings. But there's also the book that I've already mentioned, The Fourth Way, which is actually a lot easier to read than In Search of the Miraculous, but is similarly information heavy and explains the teachings for people, which Gurdjieff himself wasn't given to doing. He was more given, I think, to writing in ways that were supposed to bring people to understand for themselves, whereas Uspensky was more of a systematizer, a thinker who used to try to bring up explanatory mechanisms so people could really, you know, get what it was all on about. You could always watch the film Meetings with Remarkable Men. As I say, it's not entirely successful as a film. It's a sort of minor art house classic now, and it's interesting. And there's also a lot of magnificent recorded music by Gurdjieff and de Hartmann, performed by a great range of different pianists and musicians. Some of that's available online. You can search on YouTube. You can also look for film of movements, Gurdjieff's sacred dances, online. Some of these are of very varying quality, but if you watch a range of them, you'll be able to pick out those, I think, that are closer to Gurdjieff's intentions. There's also quite a wonderful sequence of movements, dances at the end of the film of Meetings with Remarkable Men. It's kind of the payoff for watching the whole film, and they are really, really great.